Hey everyone, I'm Mohit. I'm a developer evangelist at Salesforce. In order to start working with local development server, you will need to install Salesforce CLI. You can install Salesforce CLI by visiting developer.salesforce.com/tools/smdxcli. You will also need Visual Studio Code with Salesforce Extension Pack. You can obtain Salesforce Extension Pack from Visual Studio Code Extension Marketplace. I have cloned LWC's Recipes app project from Git. This recipe is part of our sample gallery apps. I'm in my VS Code and I have the LWC's Recipes app. I've connected to a dev hub and also created a Scratch org. Note that you will need to connect your project to Scratch org, otherwise the local development server will fail. To preview the component locally, right-click on the component HTML file and click on SFDX Preview Component Locally. Once I click, I have options to select the platform for previewing the component. For the scope of the video, I'm going to just use desktop browser. Notice that the local development server failed to start, and there is an error. Now this error is because we have not installed Salesforce/LWC Dev Server CLI plugin. You can install the plugin by typing sfdx plugins install at Salesforce/LWC Dev Server. Once the plugin is installed, you should see that there is an installed 2.5.0 version. Now to make sure that the plugin is installed, type sfdx plugins and we should see that there is a LWC-dev-server 2.5.0 installed. All right, now let's get back to our Visual Studio Code and try to preview the component. So I'll click on Preview Component Locally and select the desktop browser. Now you'll see that a local development server has started and I can preview the component. Let's say I want to make some code changes. In this case, I just want to add a label. Now, as I save, you will notice that the page automatically reloads and I can see the latest changes. I can view all of my components in my application by visiting the home link, which points to localhost 3333. Note that some components require data from Salesforce Scratchworks. For example, let's say I'm creating a record. Now this requires an interaction with Salesforce Scratchworks. So you would see that from the local development server, I'll still be able to reach out to Salesforce and the component just works fine. So here's the account we just created. We support most of the Lightning components, but there are a few components that we do not support at the moment. And to find out the limitations of that, visit our documentation. So from the documentation, it is clear that there are certain modules that are not supported. For example, Apex Continuation Module or the Navigation Service or EMP API or Platform Show Toast Event. Similarly, we have some base components that do not preview. And there are certain features like Lightning Locker and Pages, which are not available in the local development server. Now that you have learned how to install the LWC Dev Server CLI plugin and start with local development, I hope this will speed up your LWC design and development. Thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. If you learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.